Hello and welcome back to the channel. In this video I want to share with you my 5 things that I really don't like about being a programmer. And during the last 10 years I had enough time to fix at least partially these problems. This is why I want also to share my solutions with you. My first point is about feeling like a zombie after you finished your working day. And actually I saw this problem in a lot of programmers. So we're just coding some feature the whole day, normally non-stop or with small pause during the lunch, so actually we're super focused and we're deeply dived in our feature that we're implementing. So actually we don't have time to relax at all, then we're coming out of the office and we're so tired that we can't really move at all, so we're just mentally exhausted. And actually this may sound really strange because we didn't do any physical work, but we're just sitting in the office. And if you have something like this, probably you have every single day mental fatigue. Actually, this is why a lot of developers are just watching YouTube in the evening or just simply reading a feed, and nothing more. So how we can prevent this problem? First of all, what really helps are small pauses. You really need to go several times a day outside just to breathe some air like for 5 or 10 minutes. Of course, you can take a cup of coffee with you or maybe you are smoking outside. Also, it is really nice to do some exercises during the day. You don't need to do a lot, but you need to increase and improve your blood flow into the muscles. It really also helps for your brain. Also, some people are efficient with Pomodoro technique, where you are working like 20 or 25 minutes and then you are making 5 minutes pause. It doesn't work really for me, but maybe for you it will. Also, I highly recommend to do something in the evening that will turn off your brain and just change your picture, for example, by doing a workout. My second point is that we're sitting the whole day, which is really bad for our health. So we're really sitting the whole time in the office with really small pauses, then normally we're coming in the evening at home and we continue sitting, for example, playing video games or watching YouTube. And this is really not healthy and it really becomes a problem with time. The first solution here for me was to buy a standing desk. And obviously in the office nobody will buy a standing desk for you, but at home you really can do it. The main problem is that they are pricey, but from my perspective they are really worth it. Because you can really switch like every single hour or maybe every half of an hour between standing and sitting. And it really helps because you are not that exhausted during the day and when you are standing you really move a little bit. The second advice here is to try and walk as much as possible. So normally we're sitting a lot, so we need to move. At least when we're going to the office, we're going like several kilometers per day, there and back. But if you're working remote, then you really need to force yourself to go out at least once per day and try and walk as long as you can. For example, at least 10,000 steps. This is what is recommended per day per person. Also, including workouts is really nice for your health and I highly recommend to do it at least 3 times per week, it really helps. And even if you're working remotely or maybe your gyms are closed now, then you can follow along with some YouTube videos that you like and it will improve your health. My next point is fully related to programming. Actually, we can debug our code quite long, and even if you have a lot of experience as a programmer, you will have problems that you will debug long time, and you can really spend hours, days, or even weeks to debug a single problem. And actually, the problem if you are more skilled, then you have bigger problems, and probably less people can help you, and you really need to find out the answer on your own. And the problem is here that there is no solution. Actually, you just need to take time and debug your problem. And my 2 longest problems that I debugged in programming were like 2 weeks of debugging each. So actually, every single day, I sit there for 8 hours trying to debug the problem. One problem was a memory leak in Internet Explorer, second problem was with SSL certificates. And actually, both problems were fixed with less than 5 lines of code. So next time when you are debugging something, just remember that probably you didn't spend 2 weeks on some problem and maybe you have some time to debug it. My next point is about company problems. Actually, you have pros and cons in every single company, and you for sure have some things that irritates you in this current company, because there is not a best company and you have these problems everywhere, which actually means you will change the job and you will get the new list of things that really bothers you. The thing that helped me to ignore most of these problems is just changing the attitude. So I just think, okay, this is not my company, I am just working here with exchanging my time when I am coding for money, this is it. Which means it doesn't really matter if I am coding or I am sitting in the boring meeting or I am doing something with another colleague, I am just exchanging my time for money. The most important part here that you should not have overtimes. You know that you are working your 8 hours, after 8 hours you are going home or where you want and you do stuff that you like. And here is really important point, you need to stop thinking about code and office work when you are out of your office. And most programmers have problems with it. They are thinking constantly about code, about problem or feature that they are making inside office, and then they are continuing thinking at home, so they are mixing their work and their life. And the sooner you stop to do this, the better it is for your own life. And the last thing that I don't like is about technologies. So we have new trends, new languages, new frameworks every single day. And this is not bad, but the problem is that they are not mature. So actually, if we take the guy who learned JavaScript 10 years ago and now, he can't really code modern frameworks, because he didn't see JavaScript for 10 years and we really have a lot of new stuff. And it's not bad, but I can't say that this is really mature language. The same goes for tooling, we are getting new and new programs every single day and they are really slow and not that reliable. And probably most of them are using Electron inside with browser, which means they were developed really fast, but they are not that efficient. And the main problem with learning new technologies is that this is time consuming. And this is fine for the person when he is 20 or 25 to learn a bunch of new frameworks or languages, but then after some time you can see that you are getting new technologies and a lot of them are not new but the same reinvented wheel and simply another pattern or another architecture which solves the same problems as before. And also I see a lot of programs that were developed like 20 years ago and they are really super fast, efficient and not memory consuming compared to the programs that we have nowadays which were built just to be published fast. So here were my 5 things that I really don't like about programming. And if you have something similar or you want to share your things that you don't like, please write me down in the comments below. Also, if you want to improve your programming skills, I have a lot of advanced courses regarding different web technologies. And I will link them down in the description box below also, so don't forget to check them out. And if you like this video and you want to support me, don't forget to put thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And as always, happy coding!